boy YouTube, and I'm back again with another video. This video right here is taking me a while to film. I don't know why, but it's taking me a while to film, and I'm finally doing it. So if you see me change, it's because I filmed it on different days. But this video is about how to become a merch marine in 2021. Now, a lot of people have been asking me this question. A lot of people have been God DMing me, commenting. So I'm like, okay, let me go ahead and make the video. I'm dropping everything. Do you need to go to academy? Do you need to go to a trade school? The TWIC card? What's the MMC? How to go about it? I got you right here. Make sure you go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. And yeah. Appreciate all the love support that y'all been showing me lately. And if y'all see me changing in this video, man, y'all don't judge me. It took me a little while to record this. So, man, let's get right into the video. Let's do it. So, of course, y'all already know. When I come with that handy dandy notebook, I'm coming with that fire info. Like I said, I'm giving y'all everything that I know, and I'm just giving it to y'all. Y'all take what y'all want to do with it. Take notes. You know, let's do it. So, it's three type of ways you can get into the merchant industry from my knowledge. So you can go to an academy, which when you finish the 4 years, you'll have your degree. I believe it's in like maritime something. You'll have a degree, you'll come out as a mate. That's one way you can get into the industry. Now a lot of people decide to go that way, but what if you're a little older? What if you're not a school person? They do require you to have an above average GPA of at least 3.2 or more. Some of these colleges, you have to get recommended by the senator or the state. It's a lot that go into going to one of them colleges. A lot of people can't afford it. You know, it just all depends on your situation. So what if you can't go to college? What if college ain't for you? What if you're 30 or 40 and you watching this video and you ready to start working? You don't really got time for college. You got kids and stuff like that. Just apply with the companies. For example, you can go to MSC. I know a lot of people work for MSC. You can go straight to Corrali and apply. You can go straight to OSG and apply on their website. You can go straight to MERS and apply. I mean, you can keep naming companies, but you get the drift. You know, you get your credentials together. You go to these companies and you apply. You apply like as if it's a regular job. I mean, it is a regular job, but go to these companies and apply. Now you do have to be squared away, but we're gonna get into that later in the video. Another way, let's say, okay, I don't want to go to an academy, and it's kind of hard for me to get a job straight applying with the company. I ain't been hearing back from them. What else could I do? You can go to the trade school route, BLUEWATER, SIU. Them are the really two main ones that I know about. Now, BLUEWATER, they provide you with all the training that you need. You know what I'm saying? They're gonna get you set up. I haven't heard too much bad stuff about BLUEWATER. BLUEWATER is in Jacksonville. It's a little maritime academy in Jacksonville. You know, I don't believe it costs that much, but you'll have to do your own research on that. But it is a school in BLUEWATER. It don't take long. You know, if you want to get in there, you don't want to go to SIU route, you can go to BLUEWATER. Now, as far as the SIU, the program, I would say it'll take you probably about 6 to 8 months once you get accepted, and that's on the long end. That's you know, I'm speaking post pandemic. It used to take that long, but shit a little backed up. So you know, let's just say 6 to 8 months. It take you 6 to 8 months to get in. Once you get in, it's gonna take you by, I would say, a year to start seeing actual money. But the good thing about the SIU is once you finish their program, they provide you with a job. So it's not like you have to go out and look for a job. They're gonna hand you a job. How many programs, how many schools, how many academies you know gonna provide you with a job? Even when you leave some of these maritime academies, they do not provide you with a job. You gotta go find a job. So with that being said, I always recommend the SIU route. They provide you with all the training. It is free. It's free. You know what I'm saying? It's free. I don't like free shit. And they provide you with a job afterwards. Because me, the hardest thing is getting the actual job. That's how you controls 85% of the merchant fleet. Like they crew 85% of the merchant fleet in America. So if you want a job, go through them. You know what I'm saying? It just makes sense. So like I said, it'll take you about a year to start seeing actual money. You go through the phases. If y'all want a video on how I can break down each phase, people always, I said it in my previous videos, but people always tend to ask me questions about the phases and stuff, so I might just make a whole separate video about that. Yeah, anyways, it's gonna take you about a year to actually start seeing like actual money. And once you start making money, you in there. Now, that's the three ways to get into the industry. Let's backtrack. What credentials do I need? Yes, I'm gonna get there. First thing I'm gonna need you to go do is get your TWIC card. That TWIC card is gonna grant you access to all private facilities, all these refineries, these facilities. That's gonna grant you access. It's like an ID badge that allows you into the facility. The only way you can get on the ship is you have to get on the facility. So how you gonna work on the ship if you can't get on the facility? So that's the first thing I'm having you do. Before you think about getting anything else, get that TWIC card. TWIC card is easy. All you gotta do is go to like tsa.gov, apply for your TWIC card. You're gonna set up and schedule your appointment. You're gonna go into the application center, or it's something like that. It's the center that you're gonna go into. They're gonna take your fingerprint, they're gonna take your ID, and they're gonna need another form of identification to make sure you who you say you are. And it's gonna cost you $125. Now, the TWIC card will probably take you, I would say give or take, let's say 6 weeks on the far end. I always do everything on the far end, so, you know, in case, you know, something happened and get delayed. Let's just say 6 weeks, but usually it took me like a month. So it's gonna cost you $125. Once you get that TWIC card, then I'm gonna need you to go apply for your MMC. This is what the TWIC card look like. This is what the TWIC card look like. It's good for 5 years. Mine's is actually expiring this year. So this is what the TWIC card look like. When I go to these facilities, the first thing I do, I'm gonna get them this card. Say, hey sir, I'm getting on the so-and-so ship. This is my TWIC card. They're gonna sign me in, and we're gonna go from there. Next thing I'm gonna need you to do is I'm gonna need you to go and apply for your MMC. This is what your MMC looks like. This holds all your endorsements. This basically tells the captain what your job and title, what are you allowed to do? What are you actually qualified to do? This has all your endorsements. A lot of these endorsements you need to get on the ship. Other people saying, oh, you don't need your STCW. I ain't never heard of that shit. You need your damn STCW. Your basic firefighting, your basic first aid, your basic, water survival. I never heard of you don't need that shit. You need it. So that's a good thing about the SIU. They going to give you all of these endorsements. You're going to take all the classes you need to have these endorsements. But let's backtrack. How do you get the MMC? How do you get it fast? Because a lot of people are like, oh, how do I? What you're going to do is you're going to go online. I want you to look up MMC application. If you find the MMC application, you want to apply. When you apply, your application is going to go to the REC, which is the Regional Exam Center. Once it is approved by the Regional Exam Center, they send it to the National Maritime Center, I believe. Yeah. They send it to, I believe it's the National Maritime Center. Once it's processed through the REC, they call it the REC. Once it's processed through the REC and then it's sent to the National Maritime Center, I believe it's called. And you know, it goes through its process, they're reviewing it. Once you're approved, then you get your Merchant Marine credential, get an email and all that. Then you're gonna get it like, oh, you've been approved for your Merchant Marine credential, and then they'll mail it out to you. Now this process is pretty lengthy. They usually take their damn time. So I advise you, if you plan on applying to any job directly, or if you plan on going through the program, get those two credentials first, because the first thing the SIU is gonna say, if you do get approved, you have to get approved by the SIU. You have to actually apply. They're gonna make you write a letter. You have to get approved by them to enter their program. First thing they're going to tell you to do is go get your TWIC card, go get your MMC. You need to have a passport. If you already got them, you completely skip step two, because step one is applying and all of this. They're gonna ask you to send this and that, send this and that. the second thing they're going to do is tell you to go get those three credentials. Go get your passport, get your MMC, go get your TWIC. If you did that, you literally, you just jumped ahead of so many people because it takes so long to get it. So that's why I advise you get those first before you even apply. Now, the passport is pretty self-explanatory. You know, once you have those two credentials, passport should be pretty easy. Yeah, everybody know how to get a passport. I shouldn't really have to go into depth about getting a passport. Passport is pretty easy to get, y'all. Most people already have a passport. So, with that being said, let me show y'all. That's your MMC. That's your passport. And you got your TWIC. These are your Power Rangers. So, the passport, if you don't have your passport, it basically limits you to the ships you can get on, because a lot of ships go international. If you only want to stay in America, so be it. Don't get your damn passport. But a lot of people, they're just requiring it now, you know. So you need a damn passport. These are what the credentials look like in the inside. They're given to you by the Coast Guard. Looks somewhat like that, you know. It has, like, you know, all type of endorsements and things of that nature. And this is the very first thing that the captain will ask you for. Like I said, it's pretty slow. It's not as hard as people make it seem. If you have any more questions, just leave them down in the comment section. I'm going to try to answer them. I'm going to leave the link to all of these applications, the SIU program. I'm going to even leave a link to the BLUEWATER program if you don't want to go through SIU. Because BLUEWATER is a lot quicker than SIU, from what I heard. But like I told you, they don't employ you once you finish. So just keep that in mind. I'm gonna leave a link to all of these, so you can do what you gotta do and go ahead and apply and get these processes started. It's not hard. I don't want you to think the process is hard. You just need to be on it. You need to be checking your emails. You need to be you just need to be on it. How bad do you want to get out of here? Once they see how long it takes to get one of these, they just give up. Well, I mean, okay, so what? It takes you 2 months. So what? It takes you 6 weeks to get it. Once you have it, you're making $8,000-$9,000 a month. What you tripping for? Like I said, just do what you gotta do. And, you know, and if you're not where you wanna be right now, just be mindful. It's gonna work out for you. I believe it. So, appreciate y'all for supporting these videos. I appreciate all the love and support I've been getting. And I will see you in the next video.